Hello, I'm EnterElysium, and welcome back to Thumb the Depths, Allies Adrift. We have some enemies coming along. Hey, Avok.
Hello. Goomba stomp.
Not on my head. Oh, not on my
damn
head.
It.
I knew what you were doing.
Almost. So close.
Okay, so we've pulled the sub. Are we going to call the sub the Nautica?
Nautica? I think Nautilus is a good one, yeah. Considering it's probably going to be something we're working on forever. And also,
we've made it smaller since last episode.
Yeah, just slightly, because
we ran out of metal and we hadn't even finished one layer.
Yes, that was an unfortunate thing. But we are starting now on actually shaping it out. We'll show you that in a little bit. Right now, we've got other pressing matters that you can kind of see in the wireframe off in the distance. But we've actually started to shape it enough that we can sort of see where we're going to be putting things, and EE has been working on creating some actual rooms in there.
Yeah, I've got an ammo room and a fuel room and a spares room already, so it's, you know, just needs a bit of shaping, an engine, weapons, a deck, a control room, a leisure room, everything else really.
Yeah, especially the leisure room.
I want a pool table.
Hydroponics garden.
It could do with not being full of water as well.
Yeah, that's actually a pretty big one, honestly.
I do find that tends to help, really.
Now, one of the things that we noticed, and it kind of jumped to us, was you may notice we've got slightly less resource gatherers than we did a few moments ago.
I may have gone a little bit crazy and doubled the number again off camera, and we were in single digit frames.
Yes, it was really bad, and it suddenly occurred to me, well, you know, there's all this kind of cloudy particle effects coming off these lasers and the lasers themselves, and I think that's what's causing all of our crazy degraded mode FPS lag. So we shaved off a couple of layers. We may add more on, or maybe make a dedicated out of play resource gathering outpost. There's literally just a block of these things with a powerful engine. That's actually a pretty good idea, I think.
Yeah, like literally just plank of wood, giant engine. Millions of resource gatherers at outplay, leave it outplay forever.
He says that, but he knows that I'll spend hours making it look pretty.
It will be outplay. No one will ever see it.
I'll know it's there, though. I mean, this nerd pole is, honestly, if this was just slightly less ugly, I probably would have been compelled to fix it. But because it's so bad, it's kind of pushed me beyond the limits. It's effectively overloaded my brain, and I don't care anymore. I'm incapable of caring. It's killed my emotions.
Well, it is glorious. I mean, I'm up here looking at the flag right now.
The flag is glorious, but the nerd pole itself, it hurts. It's still made of wood,
and we have enemies coming.
Don't worry. The enemies are just over here. They're almost within range.
Oh, God,
almost.
They really are.
Yes, I think it's time.
Yeah,
I really think this time. Okay,
we need engagement range since we've got the range.
I'm forcing the engagement. It's going to start. It's going to be us versus them. Our gigantic, stupid high fortress. 17,600 blocks.
I'm underwater. Is the fortress actually spawned in?
We were stood on the fortress, remember?
And I got jumped underwater.
I'm sure that's normal.
It might just be because the fortress got taken out of play in the time between battles.
Yes. Okay, there we go.
Oh, hello. Yep, and I've now teleported up into the air.
Ah, good old cannon. And your missiles. The fourth missiles. Hit nothing. Right, I'm going to take my camera and go and have a look at this.
Oh, I'm too.
My cannon is annihilating the fleet over the top of the mountain.
Oh, what the hell is that that's getting murdered?
I don't know, but it's funny.
Oh, is that like weird, like, houseboat-turned ironclad ship that, you've just obliterated whatever was on the front of that. Just large chunks are disappearing.
Glorious cannon is glorious. I think you're controlling... Oh, no, the missile can't fire due to failsafe.
Yeah, I mean, you know, there's a hill in the way anyway. Although that said, it should be targeting these flying enemies.
Wow, yeah, that thing is just going away. Every time one of these shells hits, just a huge chunk of the ship disappears.
Why is the missile not targeting the flying enemies?
Did you tell it to target them?
Yeah, I did. I'm gonna take my camera down and have a look.
These shells are so... They're like the size of two blocks. Maybe even the size of a 4-meter block. I can't quite tell, but... Wow. This is... It's almost embarrassing to see how powerful that gun is. What terrible sins did we commit to deserve such power?
Okay, it's targeting flying enemies. We should see kill vehicles leaving right now.
Okay, coming up to have a look. Getting in nice and close.
They are at the limit of its range right now, though.
Then why isn't it aiming at the one that is within its range? Damn it, stupid AI.
They are there we go.
There we go. Oh, wow, these are fast. And...
Oh!
Smash. It's gone.
It doesn't exist anymore.
Nope. Four of the missiles had nothing to kill. They just went straight through it.
I'm just looking at the bit of debris that's remaining. It's just so little.
All right, the cannon has more or less finished off both ships. I mean, they're still alive, but they're not actually viable combatants at this point.
Yeah.
And it's doing that over a mountain. These things stood no chance.
Oh, more missiles are coming.
Thank you. Only two of the missiles actually connected. The rest had no point.
They really should, like, stagger them by, like, 2 seconds so they can retarget.
Yeah. Go for it. Just add
a couple of, like,
staggered fire. Yeah. Put it out to 5 seconds on it.
I mean, against larger enemies.
My cannon is going for the aircraft. Wow. Two shells was all that it took. It's accurate. And it just took out the other one as well. Two shells. This
My
cannon
is feeling left out, but you know it's designed against shrikes. It's fine.
I'm not sure the shrikes would be within range.
Come on, missiles, it's fire!
Only that
it.
The boat was drawing the attention of the cannon that the missiles got a chance. Oh no! Cannon is going for it.
Missiles, come on! No! Damn it!
Well done, cannon. You're glorious. I shall give you a glorious name.
Should we capture the boat?
Okay. Go.
Going for it. Cancel. Turn the cannon off.
Okay.
He's gonna murder it
off
fast.
There we go. May still murder it. Oh, it's still there. You got a chance.
Okay, I'm on my way.
Good luck.
There are technically two enemies.
Yes, there are. There is a plane.
There's a plane?
It's trying to drink the ocean. The whole ocean. Plane. Its balloons have been deployed, which is keeping its tail out of the water and pointed straight up. And its thrusters are firing, so it's basically trying to sink. And its balloons and its thrusters are basically fighting against each other.
Okay, I'm at the island.
Where are you? I can't see you.
I'm heading over the island.
Oh, I see you now.
Hello there, little boat. Wow, there is basically nothing remaining of this boat.
Yes.
It's like the water bit is remaining, but everything on top of it has been stripped away.
Mm-hmm. Okay, now to give you a little bit of time pressure, quickly, capture it.
Oh,
cannon
God.
Is firing.
Oh, God. I got the AI. Come here.
Gonna have to hurry as soon as that cannon can clear that mountain. It's almost there. It's almost in a position. Oh, the cannons are firing.
Oh, he killed me. The first shot to hit it killed me.
Dark Abak approves.
I hate Dark Abak. Where is Dark Abak? I will wreak terrible revenge.
Oh, that was so satisfying. It shouldn't have been, but it was.
The very first shell.
This is why you play multiplayer games, everyone. To troll your friends.
Why is the ocean... Were we always this tall off the ocean?
No, actually, every time this thing comes out and into play, it gets a little bit higher out of the ocean. I'm sure of it.
Where are you?
I'm trying to get to that other ship. Uh-oh. I can see what you're up to with that laser beam. I'll have none of it, good sir. I'm going to go and get that. when you said you found the AI. Oh, dear. Oh dear, that's not good. I don't like the idea of this. If you actually manage to kill me while I'm going over this mountain, I'm going to be impressed, though. Oh dear, oh dear. So many bullets. Ah, all of the firing things. Everything is firing at me. Ah, I'm running through the gauntlet right now.
Damn it, you got the way.
Wah-ha! Blunderbuss for victory. And the second one as well, for good measure. come here, little boat. Well, little plane. We're going to get a plane. That'll be a nice early start. Not that we'd actually wanted to fight anything, really. It would be so inefficient. I mean, yeah, flying us around would be fine, but there'd be no point in bringing it in to fight anything, you know?
Not if we've got a sub, because there's nothing to really support it.
Well, I mean, right now our fortress is stupidly deadly to everything.
This is true. If they get close enough to even get, like, anywhere near the cannon kill, they can take them out, and then any range whatsoever, the cannon takes them out.
Hello, is this your AI? Oh. Apparently it is mine. Really?
That's
not got my colours. But apparently this is mine.
I can see two things in the AI labelled vehicles, so I'm assuming that there are cannons, but I can't see it. No, it's definitely enemy. It's on the map as enemy.
Yeah, I've just taken control of its AI. It's weapon AIs, though.
That's can do that. I don't know why.
That's very bizarre. Time for grenades, I think. Need to dig my way in through the back if I can. Hopefully take over its AI. Go. Taking an awfully long time to do.
Well, we are, like, we're not in degraded mode, actually, anymore.
Yay! Is this mine now? Nope, it is still not mine. Well, that's just frustrating. I control so many different parts of it. You're just still firing that thing, hoping you get a lucky shot, aren't you?
Eventually, I'm just hoping a missile bounces or something.
You scallywag. Ah, come back here, you. I can see the AI, just can't quite get in the right angle to shoot it. There I go!
Hey.
Ah. Oh dear, I appear. Oh no. I've repaired myself inside the. I jumped up at exactly the wrong moment.
You right.
I'm surrounded by ammo barrels. If I shoot any of them, I'm going to die. No.
I like
it. Me out. Aha! I'm free! Has this thing got any kind of seat on it? I don't think it does. This is a Doc Grombleton, apparently.
Ooh.
No, it has no seat. Perhaps I should add one. Okay, well, I'll sit over here, get this repaired, and then I shall come back to visit our fortress in a moment.
I may be adding something.
Oh dear. I'm a little bit concerned. Doc, don't use those balloons to pull yourself out of the water while I'm still attached to you. Very, very loosely.
Just imagining the Doc Grombleton just flying off of you.
It's actually trying to, desperately. Okay, I'm going to come say hello with the captured Doc Grombleton in the best way I know how, and that is by riding it in the most ridiculous way I know how. Oops. About that. And dunk. Yay! I've got no means to control this. It is not built for someone to control. It is built to be AI controlled, but I'm on my way.
Did you just stick a chair on?
Yes. Of course I did.
Bodge commandeer.
Here I come. Oh, it's fantastic. Okay, now I'm going to use the camera to find out what on earth you're up to. Oh, I see.
Oh, yes.
Oosh. Haha, you're working on the missile system. Very nice indeed.
Anyone for high-yield cruise missiles?
I think I could be persuaded, yes.
They're 13 blocks long.
Okay. That sounds like it may be a little bit big, but all right, I'm okay with this.
I was going to go for like 10, and then I realized that to get to like the very top of the platform, they had to be 13, and I just went with it.
Now, people may notice that the fortress has been named.
Oh, yes. You know, we were talking about like what it should be named after and if it should have a place, and then we all realized that people probably were shouting at us last episode for not realizing the obvious.
Yes.
We're sorry.
We were focused on mythological deities and the likes, but not mythological places. And I can't even remember how the conversation went, but... I was speaking, as we were talking about the Titans, I said, well, maybe we could go with Tartarus, but... Tartarus.
I was like, yeah, I like the idea of a place, but I'm not sure Tartarus... And then we just went, doll.
Atlantis, of course. But there we are. And thus, the fortress outpost of Atlantis was born. Hello, I'm kind of falling back to the earth, very weirdly. You realize our sub is no longer going to be in the water.
Oh, God. You're going to have to just tractor beam it.
Yeah, we're going to have to tractor beam it. I'm going to have to move that into position a little further away.
By the way, I hate doing this, but for these cruise missiles, I have to stick on 3 short-range thrusters so that they, like, actually have a delay for starting rather than the ramp.
Yes.
Because the problem with the ramp is, as they launch, they're going to like not turn as well. They'll arc. Actually, they could arc.
I think it would be fine if they arced.
Yeah, especially since they're designed to go up and then to get over obstacles at like really long range.
Yeah. Just put a low-speed thruster on it. Decent amount of fuel, but mostly the low speed, because I think there's a limit to like 5 kilometers for missiles, isn't it?
Yeah, something like that. So I've got a 800 thrust thruster.
God, these
with a
10-second
ramp time.
Right.
4 fins. Just going to fill the rest with fuel.
Right.
Oh, actually, the camera is really, really high drag, so that should go at the back.
Yes, absolutely. And since this is meant to be an unguided projectile that we're going to be shooting over mountains, we can't not have a camera, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, well, while you're working on that, I am going to start work on... I'm going to build a little teleport area, like a dedicated proper teleport area back here.
Right, where's the camera? Come here, camera. Camera, 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 camera.
Mushroom?
It's a snake. Okay,
It had to be done.
Yep. Yes, it did. One turn. Anything else? APN doesn't play well with one turn, so it'll be prediction.
Yeah. Which is a shame, because APN is so good.
Yeah. I mean, I can use APN if I, like, lay the missiles out, like, along the deck, and then you use a ejector ejecting them upwards, like, flat upwards.
Yeah.
Then you put a delay on there, and that looks really awesome, but it means you have to lay them out on the deck, and then they get hit by cannon fire, and then the entire thing breaks, and it's just
difficult. So basically, no.
Yeah, I mean, they look really cool, but not if you're going to be like this, like, below the enemy's arc of fire, where you're definitely going to get hit. EMP warhead. Do multiple EMP warheads have, like, a stacking effect?
I believe they do, but I... couldn't say with any great certainty, so I'm afraid it's just guesswork on that one.
Okay, well, I've got one EMP, one explosive. Frag, 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 frag. I really wish this was like... I really wish it was in like alphabetical order.
I know. I so often lose the frag warheads because of that.
Yeah. It's not as if like they've got warheads like clumped together or anything. Regulator. Need one of those.
Mm-hmm.
and it has 7 fuel tanks, and it's really fuel efficient because it's got a 800 rather than 1,000 burn.
I just realized that I've been doing all of this without the bloody mirror line.
Of course.
Every time.
1 degree, 5 degree, 10 degree, 15 degree, and 20 degree for the frags. Okay, there are 8 ridiculous cruise missiles here.
Fantastic.
I mean ridiculous in the utmost sense of the word. I need an identify friend or foe, most definitely. I'm pretty sure you wouldn't appreciate it if I didn't have that on.
No, more than likely not. Unless I wasn't the one who got shot by it, and it was you, in which case I'd find it hilarious.
And I'm going to put 1 second, 2 second... I want massive, like, staggered fire.
Right.
So that's 2 seconds. I think what we'll do is go for, like, 4 seconds. So, effectively, like, each cruise missile will probably be a kill, so I want them to be able to retarget.
Yeah, it's a good call.
Five seconds in between each missile. Five seconds is fine.
Yeah, I think 5 seconds would be more than enough.
Yeah. I got to have a look at this Doc Grumbleton at some point.
Yeah, just jump up onto it. You can have a proper look then.
Where is it?
It's just in, it's out of play just above the fortress, I believe.
Okay. Are we going to keep it as like spoils of war?
Yeah. In my main campaign for From the Depths, I've basically got museum fleets from the various NPC factions that I've conquered.
I think that is a wondrous plan.
I've just defeated the Deepwater Guard, and the museum fleet that I'd had around my main HQ, I'm now moving over to their old HQ area. They can just patrol those areas.
At least the crew know them, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh my god, this is the slowest fill tool I have ever used.
Do you often use fill tools?
Yes, fill tools are amazing.
Alright, there we go. Proper teleporter built. Have a look, it's right next to you.
Oh, that little like shed at the bottom of the mast that you hate so much.
Yes. It's kind of built into it now, so the mast is going to have to be upgraded. It's got nice big windows, got a huge arching entryway.
You're sounding like you're trying to like sell it on some property program.
Well, I mean, you know, we're not always going to live here. You've got to have a mind to sell it on eventually.
True, you know, plan for the future.
Indeed.
You know what I've completely forgotten to do?
What?
Give this thing any sort of AI.
Well done. One of the most important parts. Alright, let's find your missile control. Also, go away, let me just grab the local weapon controller. Right, you've got... Oh, okay, that's actually fairly tightly packed, but easy for us to build on.
Oh yeah, just directly upwards effectively. That would work. Oh, there. That works too. Oh, you want to do the AI on that. I'll go to work on the... Actually, I'll have a look at the Doc Grumbleton.
Yeah, go for it. I'll just quickly throw this together.
It should be good out to, like, no limit load range, basically.
Okay. Any particular types of weapons... target priority... Oh, wait, no, it's not... It's not laser designated, so it really wouldn't matter. Do you want to prioritize the flyers with this? It shouldn't be, really, should it? Should be
not really. It should be big lumbering targets. It's still got 4 fins on each missile, but the missiles are very large. And the Doc Grumbleton has blown itself up by flying into your mast.
You were on the Doc Grumbleton for a few seconds.
I wasn't even anywhere. Actually, it's going to fall on your head.
Really? This is going to be funny.
Oh, no, it's going to fall on my head.
Even more funny.
Uh-oh. To be fair, it's falling so slowly I can dodge, but I'm trying to catch it.
I'm going to set the value per block to be fairly high. Instead of 1/10 of a point, I'm going to set it all the way up to 1 point, so it'll go for the largest things it can hit. I'm also going to drop the priority on speed to -1, so it's going to go for slower targets.
We should keep the Doc Grommeton out of play.
I'm actually going to give it 1/100th per range. Instead of a negative on that, I'm going to tell it, look, this system is designed to hit distant targets. Distant, big, slow targets. So I'm going to have it prioritize that, if that's okay.
Yeah, and then, no, it should really go for range, because your cannon like gets more accurate close range. This is accurate to any range.
Yeah. Okay, and I'm going to give it a completely neutral bias towards altitude. Right, okay, there we go.
Ah, there we go. Right, is anyone actually attacking us?
I don't think so. We could go back to work on the sub, actually.
That seems like a great idea.
Well, let's load that in before we wrap this episode up, and then we can work on that between this episode and the next.
Yeah, we'll just show them what we've done with so far.
Indeed.
I was about to jump down into the water, and that's silly.
No.
Hello.
It's just over there.
Oh, that is beautiful.
It is really, really
thing
fun.
Thing of wonder. It? Also, there's a cable going through our ceiling.
Scallywags. Stupid oil wells.
Okay, do you want to spawn it in? I'm going to grab it with the docking beam.
Okay.
I'm ready.
Vehicle is now in play. Degraded mode achieved.
Yay. It's coming down, I believe. It's not here yet.
I'm watching for it.
I can't see it.
Honestly, this thing should be casting a shadow like the moon right now. Oh no, there it is. It's in front of us, coming towards us fairly rapidly.
Oh god.
Just looming out of the darkness. Whoomph.
Oh god, I'm trying to land on it.
Okay, so this is the Nautilus so far, though it hasn't yet been named.
Yeah.
In game, that is. Got a long tail over there. These huge wings over on the sides, and this giant block of metal that leads to the inside.
And there's nothing in the top section so far. I was thinking, like, obviously the top section's going to have all the weapons and stuff.
Yeah.
So that all the valuables, like engines and ammo, go down below.
Yeah.
So
makes perfect sense.
There is actually an ammo supply if you, like, push through the side of this behind the spares crates.
Yeah, I see.
And it's got 24,000 ammo.
Whoosh. That's actually quite nice. That's very nice, actually.
Yeah, the wings are going to have giant turbines, so you can use them for lift force. And
it's
just
not going to be a flying submarine, though, unless,
I don't think
you know,
this will
maybe
fly with those turbines.
I don't know. We could probably... No.
It's made of metal. It's made of metal, not like alloy.
But I... So hard to resist. Engineering challenge.
Flying manta ray.
Flying manta ray submersible death machine.
It's designed to be like really low in the water though, so that like no one can hit it and like no one sees it and missiles can't get to it.
But I'm fairly certain, with the right motivation, read also stupid amounts of tea, I could get this into space from the bottom of the ocean.
Yeah, at like 2 FPS.
No.
We're already in degraded mode, and all we are doing is standing.
But we've also got the fortress there. Let me take the fortress out. Atlantis, go away. Nobody loves you.
Ah!
You see? Look at that. No longer degraded mode. You see?
Yeah, but it's also starting to sink.
It's okay.
Okay.
It's a submarine. It's meant to sink. Until it hits the floor, and then it starts exploding. But...
Oh dear, the ammo is actually underneath.
You fool! Why did you put it down there?
Because enemies come from above.
But the ground comes from below. And if you've not noticed, the ground is far larger than most enemies. Much more
far
dense.
Far more dangerous.
Indeed. Okay, I better bring back in the Atlantis.
Ah! God.
I can only imagine what EE is seeing right now. Oh, damn it,
I just got dumped
in the drink. Thanks, Atlantis.
I was in build mode, so I'm still here.
But, yeah, so... I'm fairly certain I could get this to go up from the bottom of the ocean using turbines to the surface of the water, then using repositioning ion thrusters to get us into space. It will be a space manta ray.
That can dive bomb people from space into the depths of the ocean.
Indeed. It won't actually need weapons. It just needs a little
Rams.
Bit of
you ram them
conviction.
From space.
Yes.
Ram them from space.
Yes.
Like rams all along the edge of the wing, and you just dive through them and shear them in half.
I just feel that I need to add a little disclaimer here that what we're talking about is probably stupid and is largely the result of a tea deficiency, or at least on my part, I've started to go into tea delirium.
Yeah,
I may not be able to design what I'm saying I can design. Actually, I'm lying. I know I can design what I'm saying I can design. It's whether I have the time and I'm not lazy.
You just need more power.
Tea gives power, but I don't think there's enough tea.
Well, if we get more tea, we can try that in episode 6. No, don't give us ideas. Bad.
Yes, give us ideas. Lots of feedback. Great ideas.
And with that, if you've liked the episode, please like, not subscribe. Please consider subscribing. That way you can see more if the YouTube sub box is not broken. And of course, go check out Avak's perspective of that horrific fight and me trying to murder him, which was unsuccessful, and him trying to murder me, which was successful.
To be fair, I didn't murder you. I just told my cannon, I no longer had your back. It was free to do what it was always designed to do, and that is
wreak
havoc.
It was bad parenting.
No. I may have patted it on the belly when you died. Only a little, though. I was a good creature keeper in Black and White, I'll have you know.
Where are you?
Oh, dear.
Come here.
Be very, very quiet. Oh, my lord! I need a Gatling gun! No!
Ah!
I'm gonna go somewhere where he can break everything but me. I'm fairly certain there is no friendly fire. I am saved!
Are you sure?
I hope. Uh-oh. Ouch! Ouch! That really hurts! Ow!
Die!
No! No! Ow! It
this
really,
is why I
really
have a minigun. And yeah, until next time, stay shiny.
Also, don't trust EE! He has a minigun!
You had a cannon!